do, then they start finding fault. Jone maro chokro kevo che, e tomaro dhyan rakto. Actually, it's not that they're not taking care, but you have no goal in life, no meaning to life, no purpose to life. Je badu hatu pati gayu, and now you have nothing. So you hang on and start living your life through your children. That doesn't work. Are you with me? Yes or no? You have to have your own. So therefore, in our Hindu scriptures, so beautifully it is given, if you know how to live life, you live it to the fullest and outgrow it. Go to the next stage. Live that to the fullest. Outgrow that. Go to the next stage. And if you can do that, you attain greatness in your life. You attain the final goal that you and I are meant to attain. Okay, by the way, let's just at this point pause and think about the importance of human birth. It's the most important birth that you can ever think of getting. And you have got this most precious human birth. Jantu naam nara janma durlabhamataha. On this hand, in this palm of mine, there are millions and billions and billions of bacteria. Is it true or not? Viruses. I've just washed my hands and come. And yet there are so many of this. Then all the living beings that are there, you know, human birth is rare. Is it true or not? The roof and crown of creation, the absolute best amongst, at least in the, on earth. Do you agree with me? Yes. It's not so easy to get a human birth. And don't think just because you're a human being now, you're going to be born again as a human being. No guarantee at all. In fact, it could very likely be because yathamati tathagati, as your thought. Some people very, very lazy and all that, then definitely buffalo birth. Bhagwan says, why give a human birth and waste the entire this? Why? Because he prefers padi. At least a buffalo to ena kene paada ni jem padi royo. So you call a human being ke paada ni jem padi royo. You never call a paado ke jone manas ni jem padi royo. You understand? So therefore, you understand that don't think you're going to get this birth again. It's a precious birth. And what do we normally spend it in? This is a lovely story. Please remember this. If we understand the importance of the human birth, then every age becomes an important age. Because many times we feel, ke baddu, you know, by the time we become old, baddu pati gayo. Abhi to kahin chhej nahi jeevan ma. Aya, what are you talking? Everything is only young age and the old age and the pachi, there's nothing in life. Are you? Some funny ideas we have about life and its purpose. In fact, most of us never even think of what's the purpose of life. A man sat in a train and then the ticket collector came and said, give me your ticket. He says, I don't have a ticket. He's saying, how can you not have a ticket if you sat in the train? He said, okay, which station did you get in from? He says, I don't know. I said, what do you mean you don't know which station you got in from? He's saying, I don't know. Some station I got in from. Okay, where do you want to go? I don't know. Hurry. But why did you get into the train? He's saying, I don't know. What do you call a man like that? Pagal, isn't it true? You and I are all like that. Why are you born? From where did you come? Mother's womb. Okay, what's the goal of life? Most of the people you ask, now what is the goal of your life? Especially if they are young, they'll say, I want to become an engineer. Now, becoming an engineer cannot be the goal of your life. If becoming an engineer is the goal of your life, the day you become an engineer, you should die. Because you fulfill the goal of your life. Becoming an engineer cannot be the goal of your life. Becoming a doctor cannot be a goal of your life. Becoming a millionaire cannot be a goal of your life. Becoming a Miss Universe, that's a very common thing in India nowadays. Cannot be the goal of your life. Why? Because then, the day you become that, you should die because you fulfill the goal of your life. Are you understanding that? The goal of your life is not, no one knows. What's the goal of your life? What are you living for? One person said, I don't know whether I eat to live or live to eat. I don't know. So therefore, we must understand, okay, what is the goal? Why am I living? One person said, because I don't die. So I live. Is that the reason to live? Why am I living? What's the purpose of life? You know, near a village, there was this small village in India, hillock. And just outside the village, In a small hut, one Babaji, a saint, used to live. Saint, you call a monk. The people of that village used to see him doing some really funny thing. Early in the morning, he'd take a big stone, a boulder, and he would push this rock to the top of the hillock. And that would take him a solid 6 hours because it's huge and he push and push and push. And by 6 o'clock in the morning, he'd start 12 noon, he'd reach the top. And then what would he do? He would push the boulder from the top. And the boulder would go down and he would laugh. Ha, 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 ha. The next day morning again. And people thought he was. So they used to call him Ganda Baba. Ganda Baba. Mad Babaji, mad Swami. Now what happened? Some great scholars and pundits from Kashi came. And they came to the village and they asked these villagers, you know, we heard that there's a person like that, staying somewhere close to your village. Is that right? He's saying, yes, the description fits completely our Ganda Baba. Oh, there is a person like that, but he's crazy. He said, no, he's not crazy. He's one of the great, great person. Please take us to him. And these pundits from Kashi went there and had a lot of discussion for a day, 2 days. They used to keep talking with him and then they went away. Then the people of the village thought that really this guy must be something, because these great people come and talk with him, have discussions with him, prostrate in front of him. He must have got something. So what happened? They went up to him and said, look, Babaji, we don't understand what you do. Can you explain what you do and give us knowledge like you gave those people, give us knowledge? And what is this you do every day morning? Ha, 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 hoo, hoo. What is this? Can you explain that to us? He says, yes. He says, how much time does it take for the boulder to be dragged up to the top of the mountain? 6 hours. How much time does it take for it to come down? Bolo. 1 or 2 minutes. But when it comes down, it makes a lot of noise and da-da, doom, doom, dam, doom. So it's a lot of fun. So I enjoy that, ha 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 ha. And then again, when it goes right to the bottom and then right from there. And then, and this goes on and on. He says, same thing happens. Human birth, the rarest of rare. Jantu nam durlabha. With all the punya, you got this human birth. And now what are you doing? Ha 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 ha, khao piyo maja karo. And then what happened? And then what are you understanding? Durlabha, the most precious birth. You can do things in this lifetime. You know, there's this man who would drink, he would eat dahi, curds, yogurt, morning, afternoon, night. So someone asked, what is this? Why don't you have milk or something else? He says, nay, nay, nay. I want dahi. So he was asked, why? You don't like milk? He said, I like milk, but I'm going to have dahi. He said, why? He's saying, if I'm born like a goat or a sheep, I will get dudh, but I won't get dahi. You understand? I'll get milk, but I won't get. What is the meaning is that what you can do in this birth, you do in this birth. What you can do in other births, why waste your time all your life doing what? Are you understanding that? So therefore, nar janma durlabha. Having established that it is this, then every age is important, okay? No age is more important, less important. Every age is important. It's got its own beauty and it's got its own importance. In fact, if you see, the old age is one of the age of great maturity and wisdom, because you've lived life. You've gone through so many experiences. And there is no more that fluttering and I want this and I want this. No, it's all gone. Vayasi gate kaha kama vikarah, isn't it? No passion and all that doesn't make your mind go haywire anymore. It's gone. So therefore, your mind is available for, and you see great artists and great people, a lot of them, their best works have come up when they were what? In their vanaprastha or in their elder age. Is it true or not? Tulsi Dasji wrote his great Tulsi Ramayan at the age of 85 years. Are you aware of that? 85 years. Some of the greatest singers, you know, and they have blossomed and given the best of performances in their what? Old age. Because the skill is there, along with the skill, there is a maturity and a wisdom which has added beauty to their fantastic skill. So it's the most beautiful. In fact, it's one of the, you know, and people say, no, old people, you look bad. No, there is a beauty to old people. Is it true or not? It's a very different type of beauty from a youth's beauty. But there is so much of beauty. There is serenity sometimes. There is such a lot of, and those lines, don't think they look bad at all. They have their own beauty also. Swamiji, we don't agree. That's your problem. But if you can see beauty in that, I tell you, it is beautiful. Have you not seen very? Nothing alag to beautiful? No one seems to agree. Anyway, I think there is such a beauty, there's such a charm. I have seen some really, really beautiful faces which you just want to stare. You know? You say, Swamiji, you're talking like a weirdo. Not at all. I'm telling you, there is so much of grace, there is so much of maturity and serenity and beauty to that. Even physical beauty is there at that. It's a different type. You understand? It's a different type of beauty, but there's a great beauty. And we should never, you know, dismiss off, you know, old age as though, only problem. No, it is not there. There's such a joy in that age. I have seen people who are so happy being old. And they live it so beautifully. And you envy them that, you know, poise that they have. Okay, physically they may be weak, but there's such a poise. There's such a joy in their life. I'm talking from sheer experience of having known people like that, lived with people like that. And especially, now when people say, you know, Swamiji, what is Indian culture? Or what is Indian philosophy? Or this, see, one of the basic things about our philosophy is respect for elders. Isn't it? One of the very important things is respect for elders. By age must be given respect, full stop. So whenever an elderly person is there, the young person immediately what? Gets up. And if the person doesn't get up, then they say the prana of that person gets up, and then he physically doesn't get up, there is an imbalance in his prana. Are you understanding? So for the very sake of balance of your pranas, the minute you see an elder person, it's a very natural thing to get up. First thing that is respected is age, then knowledge and wisdom. All these are respected. I know my telling you is not going to induce it. It cannot happen. I'm only telling you a few things. Now, very interesting. You know, how should one spend their time in the what should one do, or how should it, what should one not do? What should one realize? There are some beautiful things that are said in our scriptures. First of all, understand, it's not old age only, it's any age. Nalini dalagata jalamati taralam tadvajivitamati shaya chapalam vidhi vyadhyabhimana krastam lokam shokahatam cha samastam Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam, Govindam Bhaja Mudhamate. He said that life is extremely chapalam. And how chapalam? This is a beautiful analogy given, that there is a lake and there's a lotus growing. And you know the lotus leaf always stays above the water. And then a drop of water falls on the lotus leaf. And then what happens? The water is shaky because of the wind. So the ripples are shaking the water. So the leaf also is dancing on the top of the water. And the small little drop of water is also dancing along with the whole thing. And when will this water, I mean this drop of water, merge with the? Any moment it can go into the mid. Life is like that. Don't we see that many times? Ki pila hota, kya gaya? Gai kale to joya, kya gaya? Gaya, aur apun gai kale, yesterday, that was yesterday. Aaj, isn't it true? And age is no... 50 varas na jata. Ha, 50 varas. 40 varas na. Or 20 varas na. Su thayo. Is it true or not? Any age? Atishaya. Death. Again, forget about death. Ayur nashyati pashyata. Now, what month is it right now? Huh? September. You say that January was just now, it was January. And now? What? Are navratra aviko? Aju navratra avi aju to? Is it true or not? Ketla loko to ke Swami ji, aju to lagan thaya, on etli var ma chokra hai, on chokra an lagan thai gaya. Em lage it's just time is just. Don't you feel like that? Time is just going like that. Ayur nashyati pashyatam pratidinam. Yatikshayam yavvanam. And life just ebbs away every day. As you see, it is morning, before you know it. Don't you all experience that? Just like that. Nashyati. You become older, you become this and that. Yatikshayam. And pratyayanti gata punar nadivasa. Kalo jagad bhakshakaha. And the days that have gone, try as you will, they never come back, isn't it? I'm going to do a nice experiment with all of you. Okay. What do you think about the most? Do you think about what I want to do or what you've already done? Most of the time. If you think a lot about what you want to do, then you are young. And if you keep talking about what you have already done, you are? Now you find out for yourself. Isn't it? You become older. But everything, you're just living in the past. Both is wrong anyways. Living in the future or living in the past. And what are you doing? You are missing out on the most precious and the beautiful present. Life is only in the present. It is not in the past or the future. The future has not yet come. We don't know. It's unknown. And the way you think it is, it may never be. In fact, 90% it will not be. Isn't it true? You don't know what's going to happen in the future. So it's only an imagination. Future, as far as we are concerned, is only an imagination. And past is dead and gone. And what are we doing? Most of the time is either the past or the present. You see, most of the elder, Amara Jamanama, and it starts. In our age, and then they keep quoting price lists. Have you seen? Elder people have this habit. Ghee used to cost so much, and oil used to cost so much, and rice used to cost, and they remember all the price lists. Today, what is happening, they won't remember. But 25 years back, what all was the price of everything they remember, and they keep on quoting. And the people say, Pai, jhaswe ave, pad, amna ache, tenu su. અમારા જમાનામાં છે અમારા વખતમાં આમ અમે આમ જ કરતા અમે એન્ડ ધ યંગસ્ટર્સ ગેટ વેરી ઇરિટેટેડ યુ અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડ દેટ વોટ ઇઝ ધીસ યુ ઓલ ધ ટાઈમ લિવિંગ ઇન ધ પાસ્ટ સો રિમેમ્બર ધીસ ઇઝ વન ઓફ ધ વેઝ બેસ્ટ વેઝ ટુ ડિસ્ટ્રોય યોર પ્રેઝન્ટ ટુ વેસ્ટ યોર પ્રેશિયસ પ્રેઝન્ટ ઇટ્સ ગોન ઇટ્સ ડેડ ઇટ્સ ઓવર. And what happens, especially the older you get, what are the things you remember more? It's very interesting. You start to remember all the wrong things, especially the more you come near to death. What do you remember? All the wrong things you've done, you remember more than the good things you've done. Have you remember? Heard? Got this? Does it happen like that? You know why? Because the wrong things we do in our life, we do with more care than the good things. Any impression you remember of a thing that you've done with great, what? Care. So all the wrong actions, because if you want to do wrong things, you have to be very alert, because you don't get caught, you don't this. So you remember those things very, and more they come, and they haunt you, and they trouble you, and 24 hours, mane aam thai chhe, au me kem karyu, fine, now do something about it, compensate for it, then sorry, pan e jene kevanu hatu, sorry, e to chalya gaya. એને તો પતિ ગયું એમનું હવે મારા સો ધેરફોર ઓકે વોટ એવર હેઝ હેપન ઇન ધ પાસ્ટ વોટ વી શુડ ડુ ઇઝ ઉઠ્યા ત્યારથી સવાર restart life from now. Shanardham api vyartham nayam. Don't think that you can start living beautifully at a point of time. I will start doing all these wonderful things that you talk of after retirement or after certain time. It never works like that. This is a very beautiful story. You know, an old man, Shankaracharya, was once inspired. An old man standing at the gates of death. Bhagwan said, why did you come here to me now? Why are you remembering me? He says, you should have remembered me before. You should have done something good before. Now it's too late. Now why have you come to me? Then he starts giving a logic. And it's so interesting. The whole thing comes as a Shiva Aparadha Kshamapana Stotram. Have you heard of that? It's a very beautiful one. I think I took it once over here. In the morning class, I took Shiva Aparadha Kshamapana Stotram. I'm sure those tapes are available at the bookstall. So this man says, when he's now almost with one leg in the graveyard, he says, Bhagwan, I wanted to remember you when I was in the womb of the mother, but the circumstances were not conducive. Why? What was it over here? Very nicely it is given. Adav karma prasangat kalayati kalusham matru kukshau sthitam maam vinmutra medya madhye kvathayati nitaram jataro jata vedaha yadyadvai tatra dukham kvathayati nitaram shakyate kena vaktum shantavyo me paradha shiva 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 bo shri mahadeva shambho. Bhagwan, what to talk? Circumstances there were very bad. If the mother overate, I suffered. She got gas, I got compressed. Very bad, all the muscles, bones, all that in between, what freedom. I couldn't think of anything at that time. They told me, remember God and all that. I could remember my past. You know, by the way, the child in the stomach, in the womb, remembers his or her past births at that time. You know that? And only when... And then he says, oh God, I did all these wrong things. Bhagwan, you take me out of here and I will pray. This is very bad over here. I can't do anything much. So you need, the minute you take me out, I'll start praying, Bhagwan. So Bhagwan takes a promise from the jiva inside that he will remember. Then only the mother gets her labor pains. Are you understanding? Bolo. Ane ghani vakat amna cesarean karine karen, to promise kariya vagar bahar nikle chhe. You understand? Anyway. So they promise, you know. I will remember you, Lord. Please. Then Bhagwan says, okay, fine. Now, mother starts getting her labor pains and the child comes out. So Bhagwan says, now everything is fine. You can breathe, you can this and all. Then the child says, no. What happened in your childhood you could have done? You could have, done something good. Says Bhagwan, what to talk? Balye dukhati rekaha malalulita vapuhu stanyapane pipasa no shaktas chendriyebhyo bhavaguna janita jantavo mam tudanti nana rogadi dukhat rudana paravashaha shankaram nasmarami shantavyo me paradha shiva 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 bhoho shri mahadeva shambho. Bhagwan, what to talk when I was a child? Paravashaha, completely helpless and hopeless and dependent on everyone. Is it true or not? I mean, as an infant, I would just sit there and then sometimes mummy wouldn't remember and I would be lying there all wet and all for hours together. Then mummy remembers, are bichara baby, kanke nappy pera bandho nahi ause. But I'm suffering. Or anything would come, bite me, anything and everything, you know. And people also, you know how they are? Baby. And the poor thing, and becomes all red and all, and she, the baby doesn't like all this, you know. And then what happens? And then you say, kitli lal lal che, lalat thai natal budu hai kare tachi. All the time, suffering. And crying and all. And then before the poor thing has got his bearings and understood, barely understood, this is mummy and this is daddy. And the present day, they go take them to another naraka called school. Isn't it true? The poor thing doesn't even understand. Before 2 years, They take play school. Arippa namma ajutha mummy. Am I one mummy? No. Go. Learn 1, 2, 3, 4. Arippa papa. What? When did you go to school? Above 40 years? 50 years? 6 years. Isn't it true? Till that time, in the care of the mother and the father, and all the samskaras started coming in there. Anyway, it doesn't matter. So 2 years, the baby, go. So, and mummy also says, ha, mane relief, cha. Then what happens? And, you know, they, at 2 years, when they don't have any concept of, by the way, do you know, a human child, you may say, however advanced we are, do you know this angle, this diagonal line, when does this concept of a diagonal line get into a, and comprehended by a human mind? Are you aware of that?